have it with your friend. I do get pleasure in having people do an actual friend.
All right, Tony Budding here, and I'm here with Vince Shimp. And Vince had an extraordinary experience this August, right?
Yes.
And, well, why don't you just tell us about it?
Yeah, briefly what happened is a friend of mine had set out in August to hike a peak called Castle Peak, just outside of Aspen. It's 14,265. We hiked the peak about 3 hours. We were on top at about 9 o'clock. We were making our descent, and we had gotten down through the most difficult part pretty uneventfully. As we had come really off of the summit and off of really the majority of the descent, we had to traverse across the snow basin. As we were walking across it, we were almost off of the ice field, the snow field, when a hole opened up, and I literally just plunged down into a crevasse probably about 25 feet deep. And what he did is he actually fashioned two lines coming down.
Okay.
Each one was anchored right at the edge, right at the lip to the axes. The two lines came down. I had to get up on this block, so I was able to get most of my forearms up there, and you know, essentially I had to do a muscle up onto this wet block of ice. So I was able to kind of get up, get my chin over, and kind of just, you know, kind of worm my way up on top and get up on top of this and stand up on the block of ice so that I was within reach of the two lines.
Was there any risk of that wedged ice moving?
Yeah, I don't know what that risk was, but it was a thought, yeah.
Yeah.
You know, I was hoping that it would support my weight. Once I had gotten up on top of the block of ice, the lines were within my reach. All of the pieces were very narrow, slender pieces of webbing, all wet. My hands were pretty cold and wet at that point. And they said, "You think you can get up there?" I said, "Well, let me try." And as soon as I kind of grabbed a hold of them, I knew there was no way. There was no grip. There was no way I was going to be able to hold these lines. And so I yelled back up. I said, can you put some loops in these?" And not my partner, but one of the other fellows who was there helping out said, "Yeah, let me see what I can do." Pulls them back up. And at that point, then, I think is when everybody started tearing off, you know, just little straps of webbing off their backpacks, anything they could get that would be long enough to fashion a loop. And he was able to put together a series of loops on each of these lines in a knot that would bite under tension, okay? So once I knew he had enough, you know, I yelled up, I said, "Are you going to be able to do it?" And he's like, "Yeah, just hold on, and I can get loops in these." And that was the point where I know I was getting out. You know, at that point, I was literally thinking to myself, you know, thank God I CrossFit. That's going to get me out of here. You know, that is absolutely what will get me out of here. If they drop these lines, they've got loops going up in both ways, I'm out of here. No problem.
What did CrossFit have to do with this? Like, what experience had you had with CrossFit that was making you confident?
You know, I've been CrossFitting for about a year. And, you know, just in the course of an ordinary CrossFit workout week, between warm-ups and the workouts of the day, you know, there could be up to 200, 300 pull-ups in a week. And pull-ups are very strong for me in general. You know, I love doing pull-ups. So I was just very confident, and I knew because of all of the training I've done and because of all of the pull-ups I do week in and week out that it was absolutely not going to be a problem getting up that line.
Wow.
You know, so, and that's the first thing. I mean, I was just overwhelmed with confidence at that point going, I'm out of here.